It was different urban. I mean, the urban stuff from Harlem and Detroit was very popular, but the Mexicans added a twist to it. And it's funny because I don't think it's a Mexican style thing. It was the Chicanos creating a third culture. You know, I mean, everybody does that. You create your own culture that's different than the motherland. So it was alien to even Mexico. It was a Chicano, and they didn't call it that, but it was a Chicano style of doing things. We did things differently. And one, when the street level life was going on and the police were really coming after Pachuco, especially because of the Zoot Suit riots and everything, they were creating a different style. The placazos were becoming much more highly stylized. You know, it wasn't just tagging. They were creating these big pieces. Even before the hip-hop movement, the Chicanos were creating these really large, elaborate pieces of lettering and everything. People don't realize how the 30s and 40s, especially the 40s, especially after World War II, that Chicanos were creating a whole new third culture that was not Mexican or even that much American. It was a combination of both, but a whole new third thing was going on. And so it was Pachuco, but then it became eventually Cholo. It became a whole different way of doing things that nobody had done before.
So, and this is kind of a constant theme where you have one camp that says, no, Chicano was 60s. It's purely political. And then you have another camp that says, no, it's social and political, or it began social, became political by necessity. And a lot of people will say, well, they might not have been using those terms, but those seeds were really planted during the 40s.
Chicanos were used in the 30s and 40s. It might have even been used sooner. Among ourselves, it wasn't used by the bigger culture. We were Mexicans, you know what I'm saying. But Chicanos, the term was already used in the streets. And I know even when I was growing up in Watts and eventually in the East Side, the San Gabriel Valley, before the Chicano movement, we were calling each other Chicanos. We were already using those terms. I knew Chicanos as a term before it became part of the movement. I think it was already socialized among the barrio people, not all Mexicans, but especially the Mexicans that had become Chicanos. Like, they weren't quite Mexican anymore, and they weren't American. They weren't assimilating. They were creating a third culture. And we called each other Chicano. And I know that it came out of that period, 30s and 40s and all that, because people would say that's what we used. The origins of the word is always, that's disputable. If it means chicos patas, if it means Mexicanos, there are people can tell you the origins. I don't know what the actual origins, other than people of Mexican descent in the U.S. call themselves Chicanos.
And it always represented the same type of thing, regardless of its origin, right?
Right.
What would you say it
represented? The urban youth, the strange youth, discrimination helped pull them together. Always the Mexican, like African-American youth felt isolated, felt different even from their own parents. You know what I'm saying? African-American youth have the same history. They went against their own parents coming out of the South. You know, they created their own thing, and Mexicanos were doing it. And then, of course, again, there was a nexus between them. So Chicano was us urbanized youth that didn't relate to the parents or the greater culture. We weren't assimilated. There was Mexicans that assimilated, but that's not what we're talking about. We're talking about a whole new culture. We had our own slang. The calor was different. We had this, they call it Spanglish, but it was this mixture of Spanish and English. And you know, when I went to the East Side as a kid, I was amazed at how quick they were mixing Spanish and English. It was so natural for them. It wasn't that they weren't talking good Spanish or bad English. They were mixing it up so good that it really was a whole new language. It's almost like when people talk about the people in Louisiana, the Cajuns. Cajuns were Acadians, French-speaking Acadians from Canada that ended up in that area. And then they interacted with the Creole people, and then they had their own language and talks, and they created a whole new culture that's nowhere, nobody else has it. But it was a combination of Acadians from Canada, Creole, Black, white people of that area, and they created this Cajun culture. Well, Chicanos, you can say, is basically the same thing, only Chicanos is bigger. There's more of them. And they created this special kind of way of talking and interacting. Even food was different. The food wasn't quite like the way Mexico was, and it wasn't Americanized either.